this video, I'm going to show you the new file manager in Virtualmin 5.0. We've always had a file manager in Virtualmin, but with Virtualmin 5, we've introduced an all-new HTML5 and JavaScript file manager application that is faster, has some new features, and fits more nicely into the look and feel of Virtualmin. It was originally written by Alexander Bezenkov for Webmin, and we've extended it for use with Virtualmin. To demonstrate the file manager, I've logged in here as a website owner user. This user, named Blog, is one I created in a previous video to demonstrate website creation and blog installation. To get to the file manager, I click on Webmin Modules, and then File Manager. As you can see, it looks about like you would expect a file browser or file manager to look. Note that it opens directly in the user's home directory, and they have no way to get out of it. With the default configuration in Virtualmin, they'll be locked into their home directory. This, of course, is configurable, and a root user would be able to browse the whole file system. So you can see here we have icons indicating the kind of file or folder or whatever that we're working with here. So these are folders, and these are text files. And I can double-click on a folder to open it. And here you can see these are symbolic links, which can tell you where they're linking to, and then PHP files and HTML files and text files. File Manager also displays the size of a file, the owner of the file and the group of the file, the permissions, and the last modification time. Most of the functionality of the File Manager is found in the context menu. To see it, hover over a file or directory that you'd like to operate on, and right-click. Here you can see we've got selection options, we can refresh the page, which if any changes had happened, they would show up here. We can create a new file, or a new folder, or a new archive. We can transfer files by uploading from our desktop machine to the server, or we can download files from a URL to the current folder. We can copy, cut, and paste files. We can delete a file. We can edit files, and I'll talk more about that in a moment. We can rename the file. We can search within a directory or within a selection of files. And this finds all the files that have that word in them that I searched for. You can bookmark a path so that you can find things that you use regularly very easily. You can calculate the size of a folder or a selection of files. Note the selected size up here includes this folder and all of these files. And you can change the properties like permissions or ownership. But another cool feature is the file manager has a built-in text editor. So I can right-click on this file and click Edit. And it opens up a nice text editor here. I can modify the file. And notice that the icon over here changes to red to let us know that it's unsaved. And now it changes back to black now that it's saved. And I can go back to the original way the file was, save it again. But that's not all. When we open up a PHP file, we have syntax highlighting, which makes it nicer to work with PHP or whatever programming language you're using. Another cool feature is we can shrink this window down and open up another file. And now we can switch between them. So if we needed to copy and paste, we could do that. Pretty cool, huh? The edit function uses CodeMirror, which is a really nice extensible text editor for the web. And syntax highlighting works with many popular programming languages and markup languages. It's not just for PHP and HTML. All right, that's pretty much it for the file manager. Thanks for watching.